Hello, my name's Anthony Hall, and in this tutorial we're going to be looking at how I can use Metamorphic to adjust and correct the mistakes or errors that you get when you use the cloth effects in the under the effects tool and you're using deformation body sometimes. So if I just jump, so I've got a basic scene here. What I've got is I've just got four boxes and I've got on top of it a plane with lots of polygons. So if I just show you my bullet dynamics, so I've got the each one of the boxes is a static object, and then I've got the cloth, which is like I said, deforming body physics. So if it's only 3 seconds, so if I just jump to 90, you'll see here it's wrapped round, so it kind of drops and then slowly kind of goes around and settles at 90 here. However, we've got some errors and stuff look here, so you can sort this out. What you can do is you can experiment with the collision margins for both the boxes and the cloth. Now I've got the boxes separate because it helps to kind of adjust each area of the actual cloth, so the collision margin, so you can increase it differently on each one rather than the whole object. You can experiment with this. The problem is, if I was to, like, for instance, you've got like a gap here, haven't we? And we've got gaps here where they're sticking through. So if we choose one of these, so this one here, look, I've got this one. Let's say the collision, let's move up to, we're going to say 30 mil. So that's the collision from the cloth. It's like an invisible barrier around the actual object. So the cloth's kind of hitting that invisible barrier around it. So obviously, based on how fast your computer is how fast your simulation is going to be. If you've got a super fast computer, you might even not get this simulation. It just does it. And I mean, I'm working on a laptop at the minute. I'm not working on any fast towers or anything like that. So let's just see what happens by increasing it by 10 mil. So it's done it. Look, it's still a little bit of a gap, and it's even helped over here. But I've noticed that if I go around and I just say this one, it might affect this one, and it pulls it back out the little box bit. But eventually, by playing around with these, but it could take a while. I don't know. All the way around, you've got these errors. You're going to need to kind of experiment. But there is a way that you can actually adjust it with Metamorphic. Now, what you need to do. So I'm doing this not because I want an animation, some cloth wrapping around an animation. I'm doing it because I want a piece of cloth that looks like it's covering some furniture, maybe. So I've just got basic boxes, but it could be chairs, table, beds, sideboard, and you've just got some cloth that's wrapped around it, and it's in a room, so, or a throw over a sofa or something like that. So what I'm looking for is the final outcome, rather than, I mean, some people might want to go into a sculpting application and sculpt it, but I've never done that. I always do it this way if I'm going to use cloth, which I don't use it a lot. So let's imagine that, let's put this back down to 20. And let's imagine that we get this outcome here. And we want to use it, but we've got these errors. So we want to adjust these errors. So the first thing I would do is, I don't want bullet to be on all the time while this is on, because the littlest change and it's going to recalculate. So what we're going to do is we're going to save this deformed cloth object back out as an OBJ into modeler, and then let's have a look at the polygon size and stuff. So I'm on frame 90. I'm going to go to save the transformed object. Let's save it into here as cloth trans. That'll do. So I know what that is. It's going in there. We'll save it. Now let's disable the dynamics, because we've still got it. I've just disabled it. And let's hide the actual cloth object. So it's still there. We're just not using it. Okay. So let's go back through to, let's go into modeler. and have a look at that deformed cloth that we've just saved back out. And you could save that cloth on your timeline. So you can go to frame 50 and save it there if you want. So you can save it at any kind of stage of the animation. So let's load the object in. Cloth transformed. And yep, I've gone and saved the box. Now, the reason I've done that by accident is because I wasn't on the actual layer. So that's a bit stupid, isn't it? So let's go back through, turn everything back on. Dear me. And let's just enable. So make sure I'm on the cloth object. Okay. So down here, cloth. I'm on the cloth. And then let's go and do it again. Save. Save transformed object. Save over the top of the last one. Okay. And then let's jump back through into here and load up, hopefully, the cloth. Here we go. So here's the cloth object, okay? And it's just got a basic plain old dodgy looking material texture I got from the internet. And the scene's got like a parquet floor texture on. So if we look at the way it's built, and we bring up, so I've got my stats window up. So to get that up, you need to go to more and then open stats window. Make sure you're on polygons, and this is going to tell you. So this has got 30,000 polygons. Okay, so let's call it, we're not going to give it a name actually. Let's see if we can reduce this down before we take it through. So to do that, go to construct. And if you go down, there's an option that says reduce poly plus and bring this up. So this is going to try and reduce this deformed object of 30,000. So 0.5 means it's going to try and chop it by 50%. So down to 15,000. Let's leave everything the same and press OK. And let's have a look. So yeah, just under 15,000. Let's have a look at the difference. And let's put it onto texture. So I think that's not that bad. Let's do it again. Reduce poly plus 0.5, and we're on to 7,500. Can we get away with it again? And that's down to 3,000 odd. Let's see what it looks like with 3,000. I'm going to delete these others. So from 30,000, let's give it a name, double click, call it cloth, save it, let's send it through. Now I haven't moved it, so it should just place exactly in the same place in 3D space. Okay, let's remember to turn off dynamics of the original, go into our scene editor, and let's just turn this off. And then what we've got is this. Let's have a look in VPR, see how bad it looks. So remember, this was 30,000 polys. I mean, when we bring it through, let's have a look. And I will give you this scene. So this isn't subpatched. And if we're going to use Metamorphic, we need the polygons to be able to manipulate. I mean, we can have a go at trying to do it. I mean, remember, we don't need the timeline anymore because I'm seeing this as just like a modeling object. What I want to do is pull these polygons and edges out away and manipulate it so they're not there anymore. So I'm on the cloth. We could, for the time being, in fact, let's just turn the actual background layer off because I don't need it on at the minute. I just want to concentrate on the cloth. Let's bring up the properties. Right, so under add modifier, you need to go right down to Metamorphic. It'll show here, look, double click it. And then choose what you want to do with it. So basically all I want to do is I want to sculpt. And I want to use the push and pull to push and pull the points and polys out away from where these are. Now, this is where, when you first do it, if it don't work, it's because it's usually not got enough polys. Now you've got your strength and your radius. If you right mouse click, you can adjust that. And then if you left mouse click, when you do it, it needs to cling on to them first. So there we go, I've just pulled it out, look. And I've not needed to kind of sub-patch it a bit more. There's a bit more there. Let me just reduce that down a bit. So you need to click, wait a little bit, and then pull it out. So there we go. That's not bad. Let's do this one. Let's rotate around. And again, how fast your computer is how fast it's going to deal with this. So what you usually do is, let's make this a bit bigger. So I'm right mouse clicking. Is I'm clicking and holding for a few seconds for it to grab what I want it to do, and then I'm manipulating around it to adjust the errors that was in it. Let's pull this out. Now, something I didn't do is I didn't make the ground a static object, so the cloth's gone through the ground. If I was going to do that, I wouldn't use the whole of the area that I've got because it's too much. I'll show you in a sec. I would have probably just put a basic ground plane at the bottom here, just so it's the outskirts of it, like a one poly, and use that because it'll be easy to calculate as well. So let's come here. Let's just move this out. And you can see how easy it is. That's probably a little bit too far. Let's undo that. And again, let's make it a bit smaller. So I'm just going along. And like I said, I remember this was when we were messing about, it was 30,000 polys on that sub-patched object. You don't need 30,000 polys, Jesus. And then this one is what? Was it about 3.5? Just got to be careful that I'm not overlapping some of the bottom. It's not that bad. Let's have a look. Let's say I'm happy with that. So let's shut this down. And there we have it. So let's just go and turn back on. So in the scene editor, let's turn on the studio room, like so. And let's have a little look. And there, yeah. So before we had little bits sticking out the top, round the top, the side and everything. And then it's done now, ready to do. You can resave this back out of the transform object, or you've actually got it there. You could then with the actual transformed object, you can just parent it. So if you want to parent all these boxes, and we could parent them to the transformed object. So it just means that you've got an object in your scene that if you want, you can then move it all around. So I want to put it back up against this wall. Imagine it's a room and it's got lots of different furniture covered up with stuff. And so, yeah, it's as easy as that, really. I mean, I will provide this scene for you and have a go at it. But imagine you wanted some kind of, like I said, a cloth, and you wanted to cover up a table or a bed, and you wanted to use this way. But you're getting that problem where you're using the deformed object, but you're getting a few errors and it's taking you ages to figure it out. Get it. Don't play with it too long. Get it as good as you feel it is. You'll have some errors, but then, like I said, save it as a transformed object, reduce the poly size to as much as you think you can get away with, bring it back through, use Metamorphic, and then you've done it. Just do it in frame one, because you don't need to, it's not an animation. And then, yeah, it's all kind of done. It's as easy as that. So hopefully, I've kind of zoomed into Metamorphic, not even done a lot on it, but for this one, it's just a bit like your basic sculpting, but you can sculpt into animation as well. So if you like, if I wanted this sheet to kind of start, I don't know, coming to life and manipulating, animating, or like as a gush of wind hit it or something, I can move my timeline across and sculpt into it on that frame 30 maybe, and it'll animate between 0 and 30, this part of this coming out. And you've got your different tools, look, for transform, weight, colour, and so on and so forth, without going into Metamorphic too much. I just want to show you the basics of it, how you could use it to kind of sort out this error I've got with the cloth dynamic. So, again, please share, subscribe, go and check out Lightwave Salvation. The group's constantly growing. Some great people on there. If you ever need any help, you'll get it on there as well. And look out for my next tutorial.